Welcome back to The Generation Y. You're with me, Scott Sunjata Keita. It's all about beauty and how women are embracing it. And we're just trying to preach the word out there that women should be empowered, of course, through these programs. I know I'm beautiful and I know it, which is the movement that Washira and Rose are championing. Now, just some of, before we have gone on break, Washira, you're just mentioning some of the challenges that high school guys are facing.
Yeah.
But let's now focus on the achievement that us, beautiful and I know it, you guys have achieved. What are some of those achievements that you guys have been able to see?
Since Rose gave me the department of going to schools, we've gone to a few schools which have done cultural day. One of them was Nembu, which was a success that really, the word really spread out. And we've gone to Gandu. I have gotten the chance to go and talk to other schools. So it's really going out there and people are embracing it. And the most amazing part is having people sitting down and listening to you. That's an achievement to me, because most times we talk to be heard, not to be listened. So the fact that you find people are seated down listening to you, that shows that we are making impact. Or even walking down the streets and someone tells you, I know you're from, you know, I am beautiful and I know it. Or they want to know how they can come on board.
Amazing.
Yeah, and also schools calling you and they're booking you actually in advance for 2016.
Wow.
They're like, ours will be first term, second term. We need you guys to come. So that's an achievement for us, that word has already spread.
Spread,
yeah. And every journey begins with the first step. So that's the first step that we have made. And I'm believing that we're going to go very, very far.
Amazing stuff. Yeah. Rose, what have you seen as some of the greatest achievements?
Ah, we have some amazing achievements, I'm telling you. Because you see, like, one of the things that I'm trying to do with my company, like, being a makeup artist for the past 8 years, it's not been easy.
Yeah.
Like, the first 3 years, I really struggled. I had to work, like, for a whole year with no pay.
Wow.
Now, imagine how I was paying my rent.
Wow, yeah, I know.
So, like, one of the things, women go through a lot. Apart from the beauty part, because, you know, people use beauty to abuse women.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're people think women are the weaker sex.
Mm-hmm.
So one of the things, because I know that, is creating employment for young girls. Like, I do training. I'm a professional trainer. Actually, we give the best makeup training in East Africa.
Mm-hmm.
Makeup by Rose.
Amazing.
So, like, what I'm doing now is mentoring young girls and training them for free and getting them employment. So the good thing is we already have a few, like 30 companies on board who actually do not even have to interview my student.
Okay. Out of the
exactly.
Ones
out of the
wow.
ones that,
wow.
that we mentor,
wow.
like for free, they actually get employment, whereas they would have suffered
mm-hmm.
without us.
Mm-hmm.
So we the one thing that we understand is that women go through a lot. Trust me, women go through a lot to get employment and acceptance in this society. Because
mm-hmm.
you see, it's either someone will ask me for a sexual favor,
mm-hmm.
I have to be abused and take it for like months, a year to get that employment, I have to know someone. So what we do is we, you know, we have our own shortcuts to do that. And the good thing is that because of the amount of years of experience that we have, companies trust us. So we actually have people coming all the way from Tanzania, Sierra Leone, Romania, India for the training. So like what we want to do is to have like a full mentorship for these young girls, especially like what I'm working with a couple of people from the slums where it's not yet solid, but what I want is to be able to get those young girls who never have gotten the employment in Nairobi, you know, just to give them a start in life, to give them hope. We're also working with Heshima Kenya. It's kind of like a home for refugees from all over the country. Those women have been through hell.
The Boko Haram.
So, yeah,
especially, yeah,
so
and how old did you, because I, of course, read in your profile,
yeah.
but you have also gone and spoken to them.
Yeah.
Like, what gone through that brutal process with the Boko Haram. How
and,
was it?
And all
the,
it was amazing. Yeah. You know, you think you have issues until you talk to people.
Yeah.
Because, you know, women, like I'm telling you, women, the reason why someone would get a woman and rape her, because of the beauty part. You see, beauty is a very huge subject. Okay, that's why we are abused. You know, you go to work, your boss wants to sleep with you. You know, like from speaking to those women, they put a smile on their face and you're like, why was I complaining yesterday? And this woman has been through this. Yeah, and the one, like the Heshima Kenya, the one thing that we want to do for them, because what they need is a trade. They need a skill. So some of them, like a group of like 17 of them, want to learn like cosmetics and beauty, so that makeup by Rose will train. So we also put together like companies training in different things where the women can get trainings and actually get products to get them started. Yeah, so that's actually one of our biggest achievements, and we hope we and pray to God that we get more support. Yeah.
And Washira, of course, you also have your own mentorship program running. What are some of the things that you're running on the side, also, say in conjunction with the beauty program?
I run a mentorship program called Game Changer. Reason being, I have been a teenager before. I know what it takes to be a teenager. And first of all, I'm grateful for the fact that I never had busy parents. My mom and my dad were on every call, find out where I am, who I'm with. And so growing up, they have given me that voice to reach out to other people. And I remember when I was very small, I had dreams. I wanted to be a pilot, then it died.
Well, usually just wants to be a doctor at first, then the pilot, then the engineer.
For me, it was a pilot. Then after I saw that 98 crash, I changed.
You changed your mind.
I was like, maybe I could try being a news anchor. So when I was growing, I was really a computer geek.
Oh, okay.
So my dad and my mom knew this she could end up doing IT. So I remember when I finished my form 4, it was, what do you want to do with your life? So the first thing was, this she can do IT. So I was like, no. Being behind the computer is fine, but not what I want to do. So I joined and I did my journalism and mass communication. And when I was in that path, I would watch Julie Kishuru, Janet Mbogwa doing their thing. And I'll be like, one day, I want to be like them. But as I pursued my career day every day, I came to love public relations. And it is in this point whereby I discovered I could talk. But before that, I had won awards and medals of being a very good public speaker and a mentor. And I had gone through a mentorship program which was sponsored by USAID. They picked me when I was in Form 2. So I did a lot of peer counseling and everything. And so one day I sat down and was like, I need to talk to the young people and try and understand them, because people don't understand teenagers. They are very much misunderstood. They will behave in a certain way and you're like,
this one is not okay.
So I met Anitandero when I was working at the Insider magazine. I was the senior writer and I was doing a lot of PR for them. So after I left, I met up with her and I told her about my dream. And so she told me, go back, come back with a document and I'll see where I can come in. So I gave her my document and she gladly told me that I want to be the face of this program. So with my experience of 9 years working with youth, it has really been amazing. I've been to, I don't know how many schools, I can't even count, but this is a face they will relate with. They will see me and they're like, Jackie, that's her name. And the fact that Rose easily picked me, I feel as if it's a calling. Yeah, it's a calling. And there are things you cannot run away from. Because even in church, I sit with people and people are like, no, Jackie is going to deal with the teenagers and the youth. So you see, you can't run away from me. So I've come to accept this is it. And it comes from my heart. Yeah, so I enjoy what I do. And I think this is the thing that will take me to my grave.
To the next step.
Yeah.
Awesome stuff. You're watching The Generation. We're going to take another short break. We'll be right back.